Okay guys, welcome to another tutorial. Today we're going to talk about the Skierg, which is for most the most unusual and uncommon movement as far as cardio machines go, because the rowing, the biking is a much more natural movement pattern. There are some very important details when it comes to technique on the Skierg. Actually, it's a very nice supplemental machine to the rowing machine. If you just use machines, if you just could choose two machines, it would actually be the rower and the Skierg, because on the rower it's more like posterior chain and you pull, and for the Skierg it's more like a pushing movement, like pushing straight down, and you're also using like your anterior chain, like the muscles on front of your body, like your abs. You use your legs for deceleration and also your hips to close at the hips and hinge over forward. And this also lets you use your body weight. And if you do it correctly, you can develop a quite efficient and good technique on the Skierg. Obviously, the first thing you need to do is grabbing the handle. The flat part of the handle should always point back, and you want the handle as deep in your hand as possible, and then close your grip lightly. We don't want to over grip it, because this will lead just to excessive grip fatigue. So put the grip in your hand, grab it with your fingertips, close the hand, put your thumb on top, and that's basically it. For the most efficient technique on the Skierg, as I said in the introduction, we want to use our anterior chain. So as you can see, Jordi is mostly hinging at the hips by pushing his hips back and leaning over. This lets him use his abs and his whole abdomen to crunch over and pull the handles back. Also, he's pulling with his arms and his triceps. What we're looking for here is a bent arm at 90 degrees. A bent arm is always a strong arm on the Skierg. And when we have our arms at a 90 degree angle, we're basically our strongest, because this is the position we can hold the most weight in and we can pull the most weight in. And this is basically an isometric contraction of the bicep and the shoulder musculature to fix the arm into this position. And then we're pulling back our elbows close to our body. And this allows us to use pretty big muscles on the back. For example, the lats and all the muscles surrounding the shoulders who are responsible for pulling the arm back. And in the end, we have a small push with the triceps. So what you can see at the end of each stroke, Jordi is extending the arm to make the stroke nice and long and really efficient. As on the rower, timing and rhythm are very important on the Skierg. For example, most of the time, if we ski for a longer distance, obviously this changes when we do like sprints or short distance style training. We want basically a rhythm of 1-2. 1 is our pull and 2 is our recovery. 1 is our pull, 2 is our recovery. You can see that when Jordi is skiing and basically count it for yourself, or you can also do it as you're skiing and count 1 for your stroke and 2 for your way back for your recovery phase. For the correct timing on the Skierg, we want to wait until the last moment until we extend our arms. In comparison to our shoulder musculature, to our back musculature, and also to our entire anterior chain, our triceps muscles are actually quite small and they don't contribute as much power to the whole movement, to the whole pull or stroke, however you want to call it, into your pace. Now we go over some of the most common mistakes on the Skierg so that you don't make them. The first one would be pulling with straight arms. When we're pulling with straight arms, the handle is actually very far away from our center of gravity. This makes it very hard to apply force to the strap and increase the speed of the flywheel, which is basically the most important thing when skiing, like increasing the speed of the flywheel to create drag and also have a high or like a fast pace. The second mistake is that people don't finish the actual pull. So we want to increase the range of motion or use the full range of motion to get the most out of each pull we're doing on the Skierg. The last mistake we want to go over is squatting. Shifting your knees forward like you would do in a squat and taking all the load from your posterior chain and also reducing the range of motion of the stroke. Another thing to think about when setting up the Skierg is setting up the right damper. And selecting the damper is always requiring taking into consideration if you're like a heavier female, a lighter female, a heavier male, a lighter male. We always recommend for lighter athletes to set the damper somewhere between 4 and 6, depending on the distance. And for heavier athletes, something between 6, maybe even all the way up to 10 in some instances. When we're using the Skierg in a CrossFit type of scenario, we sometimes have to sprint because we do a short amount of calories in a very quick time, or we do intervals where we rest and then go back to the Skierg and then race again. And for that, we use a technique that's called the sprint start. When we set up for the sprint start, we kind of take a split step into it, like a bit of a lunge. We have most of our weight in the front leg, and then we grab onto the handle. This places our foot right in underneath our center of mass and gives us the most balance. As we pull, we go back and step back into the whole stroke. Okay, thank you, Jody, relax. As you could see, he was increasing the length of his pull with every stroke. But when you do it in an actual workout, you would do it a bit more aggressively. This is what Jordi is going to show us now. Show us your regular sprint start. Okay, very nice, relax. As you could see, by the fourth or fifth pull, Jordi has reached the full length of the Skierg stroke. And that's what we want to do. The idea here is we want to get the flywheel moving as fast as possible. And in the beginning, it's harder to get the flywheel moving than as it is spinning already. So we're doing basically just a crunch and then a half pull, then a three-quarter stroke, and then the full Skierg stroke to get the most out of it and increase our pace as much as possible right from the beginning.